I'm Kevin Adams, and I am a former Mistra Geopolitics researcher. I'm now a researcher at the London School of Economics and a foreign affairs officer at the US Department of State. I'm also the lead author of the report Climate Change, Trade, and Global Food Security. For me, this piece of work is so important because when we think about how climate risk can be addressed, we very often think about it in an isolated way, and we don't think about how countries, companies, and communities can and should be working together to address those risks as one unit. Climate change poses a number of risks to global food trade. Normally, when we think about climate risk in agriculture, we think about how drought, extreme weather events, wildfires are going to affect agricultural production in one specific area. But we often forget that because countries trade, that we are fundamentally exposed to climate risks that occur in other places. So as one country is exposed to a climate risk, it's going to affect all of their trading partners as well. The risks vary substantially across countries and commodities. From a country perspective, it matters first what your diet as a country is, so what sorts of things are you eating. But it also matters what your import and export profile looks like. Are you growing enough of that food on your own and in fact exporting it to others? Or are you very import dependent on the commodities produced other places in order to eat properly? There are also significant differences across commodities. So for staple commodities like maize, rice, and wheat, there's going to be different dynamics than for commodities like soy and sugarcane, which are very embedded in the production of other goods, which are again very different than something like coffee, which is not necessarily got the same food security dimensions included in it. For countries like Sweden, and including many of the others in the EU, those countries tend to be very import dependent and are very dependent on food produced in other places. Coffee is a really interesting example in this case. Sweden does not grow very much of its own coffee, nor do many other European countries. So if they would like to be sure that their coffee supply is resilient and secure far into the future, they need to identify ways to work with coffee producing countries to make sure that the whole supply chain is climate resilient. The first thing that countries and companies need to do to manage these kinds of risks is to work to identify where they exist in the system currently. At present, when we think about climate risk and climate adaptation, we almost always think about it within our own national borders, and we completely neglect this element about how we could be exposed to risks from other places. So the first step in managing these risks effectively is going to be identifying them. Second, once we've done that, we need to figure out how we can work better with other countries, with other communities, and with companies in the private sector to make sure that we're managing those risks effectively. What we don't want to see is a situation where countries are only acting in their own personal interest, only acting to secure their own supplies, but are not necessarily working together and making sure that there is a resilient food trade system that supports the entire global economy.